my god. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hi, my name is Taylor. I just recently started this YouTube channel, so I'm very happy that you are here. Welcome. All right, so I am flying back to New Jersey tomorrow, and in the most typical fashion, I have not packed a single thing. I have to run errands. I have a million things to do. Laundry, cleaning, whatever is on the list. Laundry, cleaning, just like a bunch of like little things like that. And I need to do it all today and before 8 a.m. tomorrow. So I am gonna take you guys along with me. You guys are going to hold me accountable and you're going to make me do everything that I need to do. So first on the list, I think I'm gonna check a bag. I have to finish up some laundry. I have like, I think 3 loads that I need to do. I need to clean the apartment, and then Dan and I bought like some lights to go around the couch. So we're gonna do that tonight and I'll show you guys. I'm actually really excited to do that. But other than that, mainly it's like the packing that really stresses me out, that I think is like the worst thing in the entire world, because I don't have too much going on while I'm home, but I have like a few things that I need to make sure that I have good outfits for. So that's gonna stress me out to literally no end. I'm so not excited for that. I have to like run to CVS, run to Ulta, little things like that. You guys are gonna make sure I do all this stuff, and this is gonna be like my accountability coach, because I will literally save it for 9 o'clock tonight. So we are starting now, and we are starting with laundry. Cue montage. Laundry is complete, or not complete, but like at least started a little bit more. And now I am going to do some packing. Why am I so nervous to pack? Oh, it gives me so much anxiety. I don't know why. I'm gonna definitely do a checked bag. I'm gonna turn on Vanderpump Reunion on Peacock because I didn't get to watch it last night. This was a Christmas present, I think. I got it either this Christmas or last Christmas, and it's like the Bays. It's like the large check-in bag from Bays, Shay Mitchell's company, and I'm obsessed, you guys. I travel a lot. I have a ton of suitcases and all different sizes. I've tried a bunch of different brands, and I love all the thoughtful compartments and the thoughtfulness that she put into designing this suitcase. It's the best. And my favorite thing, which I will show you guys once I'm fully packed, is that on the side right here, hold on, let me grab you. On the side right here is that when you exceed 50 pounds, and I'll show you guys once I'm fully packed, because I will most likely be very, very close to 50, is that when you exceed 50 pounds, that little bar right there turns red. So you don't have to like freak out before you check your bag. You'll know before you go to the airport, and then you can adjust from there. I don't really know how I'm gonna go about this. I think that I'm going to try to like figure out some outfits to wear for like the event occasions that I have. And then the rest I'm just gonna do like pieces that I can easily swap in and out. Okay, wait, popping back in really quick, because I'm packing the first thing. I've made no progress. But I got these Tony Bianco heels like back in like February or something, knowing that they would be the perfect like summer heel for weddings or occasions or anything. And I finally am gonna wear them on this trip, because I'm gonna do my campaign shoot. I have like a wedding guest dress look, and I'm gonna do these shoes with it. But they are so freaking cute. I love the platform. The heel is like tall, but it's not too tall. I love, love, love any heel with an ankle strap. They're my favorite things. So I can't wait to wear these. These were on the Tony Bianco website. They were on sale, so I don't know if they're still on there or not. But when I got them, they were literally like $40. I was so excited. So I'm excited to wear these. I'm almost done. I really am. Is that good packing? Really don't know, couldn't tell you, but it's at least packing. I just ran out of the house. I have to go to CVS and pick up birth control prescription, and then I'm gonna get some other like little things while I'm there. I think I need like a travel toothbrush, toothpaste, things like that. 85, 90% of the way done with packing. I just have to finish that up, and then when I get home, Dan is home now, so we're gonna go to the gym together. Either the gym or like do it like a little run outside just to get like some exercise. I don't like to have a rest day before my flight because I know that I'm not going to be working out tomorrow at all, so I definitely do want to move my body today as much as I can. So that is what's on the agenda. I lied, I am going to go to Ulta. I just got back from CVS, or I just got back in the car from CVS, and I had such a sweet tooth in there, so I feel like I needed it. I'm gonna eat a little bit now just to like satisfy my sweet tooth, and then I'll save some for dessert for me and Dan after dinner tonight. All right, let's go to Ulta. The view is a little bit better because I just shifted down the steering wheel. I'm really hoping that I can get that back up in place. I went to Ulta, I just got back. I did the typical like blackout in Ulta and have no idea what I bought. So I figured I would do a little haul with you guys. I didn't get much, I kept it pretty cheap. Everything that I bought was under $20, under like $18. So I didn't think I did that bad. But I got a few things that I definitely needed like refills of, and then I got just like a few things that I like really didn't need but just wanted to try. So first thing that I needed was this Peach Slices Snail Rescue All-in-One Moisturizer. I've gone through like 4 or 5 of these things, you guys. I absolutely love this brand. Peach Slices, I think, is like the sister brand to Peach and Lily. So they have like slightly cheaper products, but I think they're just as good. Anything with snail mucin in it, I love. Especially with my skin, it drinks that stuff right up. So I needed a new one of those. Then I got the e.l.f. Camo Concealer Sponge. Get it to not glare so much. There we go. So I like this sponge because it's, I don't really use like a beauty blender or like a big sponge a lot, but I like this sponge because it's perfect for like right under my eyes and just like any like little, and just like any little cover up spots that I have. So I really needed a new one of these because you guys saw in my last video, this was filthy and I needed a new one really bad. Then these were like things that I really didn't need to get, but I just wanted to try out. I saw some girl talk about this on YouTube. It's the Good Molecules Yerba Mate Wake Up Eye Gel. I saw her talk about it on TikTok. She said that she had like really dark eye circles and then she tried this stuff and she absolutely loved it. I definitely needed to give it a shot for myself. I'm very excited about this. And then with that, I also got Pure Cold Pressed Rosehip Seed Oil. My best friend, she uses rosehip oil religiously, so I definitely wanted to try it. These were like $10 each and I really did want to get to them both, so I'm hoping that I like this stuff. Good Molecules is like kind of a newer brand to me, but I really like their stuff so far. I tried their hyaluronic acid serum and I loved that. I just haven't gotten like a re-up of it, but they're supposed to be like completely clean. I put all of my skincare products into like this website that like checks the ingredients and it'll tell me like if they're non-comedogenic, which means like they will clog your pores or they won't. So I tried that as well. And then lastly, I was about to check out and I did pretty good, and then this was staring at my face and I needed to get it. So I got the Osea body oil. I've seen everyone talking about this, so I was like, okay, why not try it? My skin needs a little extra TLC in the summer just because like I'm sweating more, I'm in the ocean more, I'm tanning, all of that sort of stuff. So I got this stuff and I think that I will bring it with me and I'll test it out when I'm at the beach next week and like a post beach shower. But yeah, that is my haul from Ulta. Now I think I'm gonna go home. I really don't want to work out now because I was out a little bit longer than I expected to be, but I think Dan's gonna force me to work out with him because I was trying to force him. That's what I'm gonna go do, and then I will take you guys along for the rest of the night with me.
Just got home, gonna go on a walk because I don't think the gym is in the cards for us today, and then we will make dinner. done with our walk. I am going to now pack my skincare. Well, most of my skincare. I'm gonna try to pack almost all of it, but obviously I'm gonna have to use stuff tonight and tomorrow. So I'm gonna do like all of my hair care products and then most of my skincare. So I will show you guys how I'm gonna do this. Is everything that I use on a pretty much a daily basis. Some of it not always, but most of it. So I am going to pack up all of this stuff and figure out like what I'm gonna need. Tonight and tomorrow, I'll leave that out and then we will take it from there. I also can pack up all of my makeup because I'm not really going to wear any tomorrow. I'll wear like brow stuff and maybe a little bit of concealer. So I can pack up my makeup too. And then we have some makeup, skincare, hairstyling products here. And then this is what I put in like my carry-on, like my personal item. This is anything that like I might need to access during the flight. Eye contact solution, my Aquaphor, eye drops, hand lotion, anything like that. So Neosporin, I don't know. Whatever I think I might need to access on the flight is what will go in here, and this will go in my carry-on. You guys, is my tried and true face wash. I love this stuff. It's the Youth of the People Kale Green Tea and Spinach Vitamin Superfood Cleanser. Best cleanser ever. Okay, it's honestly just getting better and better. I feel a little bit better now that I have most of this stuff packed up. I have to add like my straightener. I think I'm just gonna bring this straightener and this curling iron, but I feel better now that I have a little bit more of a handle on what I'm actually bringing. I need to shower now, and then I need to finish folding laundry, and then Dan and I are going to watch the Air movie tonight, and then we have like these really fun lights that we bought, you guys, and we're going to put them behind our couch to give like some cool mood lighting to the apartment. I'll show you, hold on a second. All right, sorry for the weird angle. I'm balancing you on a water bottle. But we got these lights. I saw someone, what is this? Oh, strips. I saw someone do this on TikTok and I wanted to try it. It is these LED lights that you put behind the couch, and like you use command strips and you just put them along the couch, like right below the couch, and it's supposed to look really cool.
Yours looks like a fine dining restaurant.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
Thank you for cooking. These look yummy. It's like 7:45 and I'm leaving for the airport in about 15 minutes. I'm almost completely packed. So Dan is just making me breakfast right now, and then we are going to finish packing up and then head out. It's like 7:45. My flight's at 10:30, so we're actually going early because I'm just gonna go do some work in the airport. Miss me?
Hi, it's me. I am in New Jersey. I successfully made it. I'm so excited to be here. I'm at my family's shore house, which is in central Jersey, and I'm about to go get ready for the beach, which is my favorite thing to do ever. So I'm gonna wrap up this vlog and I'm going to start a new one for like my week in Jersey and kind of what that's like and what I'm gonna be up to. So I'm gonna wrap it up here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please, please, please like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.